Oh, hi there. Didn't see you there for a second. Wait, let me put this aside. Sorry about that. Neovim has been around for 10 whole years. I transitioned from Vim probably around 2019. I had no idea what I was doing. I picked up bits of .dot files from GitHub and stacked them together into a bloated configuration. I had no idea how to use most of the time and had no clue why it was crashing the rest of it. But this isn't the case anymore. You don't have to be a renegade. We now have tools to ramp up even a fresh user to an amazing yet professional and performant Neovim setup. The community is thriving. With plugins and plugin managers, Neovim keeps up with other powerful alternatives like VS Code, JetBrains products, and recently even Cursor AI. Video above for more on that. And while huge advancements are great and exciting, we tend to forget the little things. The things that makes this environment so damn smooth and fun to work with. The motions, the flow, the little key bindings. Every now and then, a talented developer comes along, packs up a nice set of options, and ships a new plugin. Well, today we're uncovering snacks.nvim, a tasty plugin by the undeniable king of Neovim goodness, Falk. With a new and beautiful notifier, improved and customizable welcome dashboard, integrated floating windows, lazy git, and even a Quake-style terminal that's becoming the cool kids feature everywhere. This is just the tip of the iceberg, and we've got so many snacks to unpack here, so without further ado, here's Neovim Snacks. This is Snacks, a couple of months old and already with a huge traction. Snacks lists, well, snacks for Neovim, like handling big files by preventing Neovim with loading TreeSitter and other intense plugins. It knows how to handle buffers to keep the view intact. It creates beautiful and configurable dashboards and much, much more, and we'll get to all of this in just a sec. If I have to be honest and admit my superficiality, what had drawn me first and was the main reason I wanted to try it out was the beautiful welcoming dashboard. The dashboard is a screen that holds the banner, a few shortcuts, and another configurable list for you to customize. There's a bunch of options from the community like colorful icons, an image from a gallery, maybe just a link column of useful information, or random Pokemons, because why not? What caught my eye was the fact that you could just run arbitrary commands and output any visual. Then I thought, why don't I create an ASCII version of DevOps Toolbox and use that as a visual next to my welcome screen? That can be nice. So I went with the configuration, kept all the essentials like the header, keys, and everything else, but then on the right column added a small command that takes my channel's PNG and converts it to ASCII. Sadly, I didn't find a way to pre-compute this while keeping the colors intact, but this works fast and does the job. Here's the PNG I'm using, which translates quite nicely, and here's the image converter project. It doesn't seem to be maintained anymore, but it's definitely doing the job. Let's rewind a little and look at the base installation for Snacks. There's a basic configuration that you can grab and push to lazy, or go for the full-fledged options below with preset bindings and popping windows that you can use as is or customize to your liking. I just grabbed the larger chunk, and before making any tweaks, go ahead and remove Vim Notify, which was previously used as my notifier, and probably yours too if you had something like Falk's noise plugin that comes with it. Snacks brings a nicer one. The visuals are slicker, it's easier to configure and get rid of what you want, and comes with more sensible defaults without errors lingering long seconds on your screen. With that out of the way, and with my pre-configured welcome screen because I couldn't help myself and I had to play with it, let's check out the basics we now have. First off, the welcome screen has a few useful shortcuts clickable directly or by using the bindings to the right. Here is the config files within Telescope when you hit C. Lazy pops with capital L where we can actually see snacks loaded with its list of options and their help files. G pops a live grep in Telescope for code search across your repository. There's also a useful binding for a new file, allowing for a blank new file that was previously available simply by launching Neovim with the file as an attribute. When you do decide to provide a file as an attribute and run nvim myfile, Snacks comes with a quick file configuration which will render the file as quickly as possible before loading any plugins. Going back to the dashboard, R shows Telescope with the recent files available, which is super useful as well, and I've already found myself enjoying it over the past couple of weeks having the plugin installed. Let's explore some of the pre-configured bindings to go deeper into what Snacks comes with. To start, here's a new notifier that comes as a snack, and here's the so much needed dismiss feature that comes by default as leader UN to dismiss them when needed. this was haunting me with the older notifier, especially with noise and vim, where the dismiss command kept changing. Now I can finally get rid of these messages, even though they don't stick around for that long. This is great, but are you ready for the next one? LazyGit fam, you know how I love LazyGit, and check the video above to see more. And while I had my criticism of having to hack my way around to use it within the IDE, this new snack does it too. LazyGit within Neovim. And yes, I know there's a plugin for that, and it feels like LazyGit.nvim just died too with this release. Here's a shameless plugin for a plugin, haha. My way of doing that until now was using tmux floats that pops a floating window on top of tmux and then running LazyGit in there. More on floats in the video above, but enough about tmux, we're here to talk about snacks. Git browse opens a browser of branches that you can use to look around your project. Leader.gl pops a beautiful git log pop-up with commits and a visual tree of branches, which is another beautiful quality of life upgrade snack. If you're rebasing, for example, you can actually hit a commit to view conflicts, abort the rebase session, and more. The little branches even highlight when you hover on them. You can hit a commit to see the diffs it created and the commit itself. There's a bunch more snacks on the list, like a rename integration for users of NeoTree or mini files, a nice status column, and here's another cool little addition that can upgrade your life. I've always wondered about the relation between Neovim and the terminal. I even made the video above that covers the different options and my picks, but here comes snacks and gives you a pop-up terminal that you can trigger whenever, use, and dispose. We all have random ways of solving this issue, whether with my tmux floats, as I mentioned earlier, Zellig has its own pop-ups, others use multiplexing from their terminal, but snacks just beautifully uses the built-in terminal to give you quick access that you can also configure and change the size, location, and more. In addition to the previous git log feature, snacks comes with additional git options, like a nicer blame that pops the current commit in a floating pane, pretty useful and colorful. A fresh change for those of us who are used to git fugitive. For those of us who enjoy Neovim plugins development or just want to configure a pop-up to show them the news or whatever other quirk, snacks comes with a window module that you can use to set floating panes, integrated ones, use them as a terminal, a new buffer, lint style, or a full-blown editor. You can do it all. Lastly, here's something I never knew I needed, but now I have it in the tips of my fingers. Git browse open a browser, taking you to the remote repository of your project and literally puts you on the same line you're on in Neovim. How cool is that? This module is pretty smart and can be set to use remote patterns like SSH, HTTP, and lets you add your own pattern if those doesn't work. I'm looking at you, Azure on SSH, what the hell is going on there? I've mentioned how snacks works with mini files, integrating the rename feature, so I'd have to remind mini Neovim, another great set of quality of life tools which is coming soon to this channel. There's a ton of more options, so get snacks, play around, and please comment if I missed anything, or you think I should add something to make everyone's Neovim quality of life a tiny bit better. Having snacks installed gets me thinking. One, there's a lot more to improve and I'm going to release another video soon covering all the goodness that other popular plugin, well, a library of plugins packed together has to offer. That's all great, but without the proper basics, none of this makes sense. So in the meantime, here's my entire Neovim config from scratch, piece by piece, for both beginner and advanced users. Thank you for watching and I'll see you on the next one.